第十二队演讲的题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Good morning, dear judges and contestants. Our topic is Number One. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs is a name that is familiar yet unfamiliar to us. We know roughly what it does, as its name gives us a clue. We see it as something that deals with foreign things, and maybe we think it can only affect us if we venture out of the country.We see things in the news saying MOFA is warmly greeting important people from other countries. But do we really know what they do? Here we will project our thoughts on the work they do. First, Emily is going to illustrate the main duties of MOFA.
In all the works that the MOFA has involved, the mostly known would be negotiating all kinds of international agreements, including economy and military with other countries.For example, signing a stake with New Zealand to construct the economic cooperation, strengthening military ties with Singapore, and also participating in several negotiations in WTO. Other land-connecting relationships in economy. MOFA arranged official visits to distinct countries for maintaining diplomatic relationships, and hosts banquets to welcome diplomats or authorities from all over the world.They value various aspects to get mutually beneficial cooperation. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs needs to process various external developments and consolidate foreign relations to strengthen the fabulous image of Taiwan to the world. Because of their efforts, we have chances to bridge adjacent and distant regions. Next, Lawrence is going to talk about the relationship between MOFA and people on this island.
It may seem that the works which the Ministry of Foreign Affairs do aren't quite related to our daily life. But as a matter of fact, it plays a significant role in numerous aspects of our lives. If we don't cultivate a good relationship with other countries, we're in some serious troubles. As we know, people have traveled around the world more frequently than ever before. It has grown to us and become an important part of our lives.We can have this kind of conveniency due to the strong efforts made by MOFA. However, if we don't maintain a good relationship with our countries, we may not be able to enjoy the privilege visa-free can bring us. That is only one example how diplomacy affects our lives. Numerous other influences, no matter good or bad, are dealt upon us each and every day without any awareness. That's why MOFA plays such a crucial role in our country.Next, Aline is elaborating the things we youth can do diplomatically.
There are many ways for us young people to help develop good relationships between us and other countries. One of them is new media. One successful example of implementing people to people through new media is the case of Digital Diplomacy Kosovo.It is a Facebook fan page established by a young Taiwanese girl named Ko to help gain recognition for Kosovo internationally, thus to gain recognition for ourselves in return. To reach the goal, one of her projects is to help Kosovo by filming hundreds of people voicing for its domain in the name of Taiwan. This not only helps Kosovo advocating for their rights,but also let people who are concerned about this issue know more about Taiwan. Countless other ways, such as volunteering abroad, joining international internship projects, can also help our nation out in a diplomatic way. Thus, Jennifer is going to conclude the speech with the importance of MOFA.
We may hold a thought in our heads that these foreign affairs won't affect us,as long as we stay on the island. But that is a misguided fact. As listed earlier, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs plays a great role in our everyday lives. Essentially, we cannot live without it. It is key to our part in the global village and helps with our interaction as a whole to the world. Creating good relationships with countries everywhere is useful because help always returns itself. Can you imagine a life without the Ministry of Foreign Affairs? Thank you.
第六队的演讲题目是 Number Q， 计时开始。
Good morning, judges. In the past, diplomats usually negotiated in secret, and when it came time to share those negotiations with the public, they were announced by the leaders to only all media, which were released to newspaper, television, radio, and magazine. This kind of traditional communication can be seen as the model of from one to the many. Under this condition, people could only receive the results of diplomacy and not do anything to help or interact with diplomacy. However, with the rising of new media, the methods of conducting diplomacy nowadays have changed dramatically. Now, let's invite Dan to give us some explanation.
Thank you, Angel. Well, some general features include interactivity, mobility, and network. The following are good examples of new media, like Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. They all belong to the category of social media, which allows faster, easier, and more interactive ways of spreading information. This kind of novel communication can be viewed as the model of from the many to the many. Living in an era of social media diplomacy, people can get more involved in and connect with the world than ever before. What do you say, Vicky?
Thank you, Dan. The meaning of diplomacy today is much simpler than before. Soft power, such as culture, education, and product maintenance in Taiwan, can be regarded as diplomacy. Thus, how can we use new media as a diplomatic tool to make the world more aware of Taiwan? Given the popularity of Facebook, we can set up a fan page for Taiwan in order to increase the exposure of Taiwan to the world. Content about traveling in Taiwan will be designed and posted in both Chinese and English to attract the maximum target audience. Peggy, we have more than that. Can you explain more?
Of course. Facebook has a video streaming service called Facebook Live. It allows users to connect with their audience and follows on Facebook in real time. Through the interaction between streamers and followers, people might have a favorable impression of Taiwan. With cell phone and tablets connecting to the internet, everyone can receive and exchange information anywhere and at any times, which means there are no more limitations of spreading information. This is how people diplomacy conduct.
That's right. What about YouTube and Instagram? They are more personal, which means everyone can increase Taiwan's visibility to the world through them. In addition, we are inspired by two world famous Mario games, Pokemon Go and Travel Frog. People all over the world have downloaded and played these games. Therefore, we would like to introduce a Mario game which is about encouraging people to come to Taiwan for any rewards. Now, let's invite Dan.
Thank you, Angel. Special features will be included to draw players' attention and arouse their curiosity about Taiwan. We also want to cooperate with Google Maps to create augmented reality games. By promoting Taiwan only special rewards, players get rewards as long as they pay Taiwan a visit in person. We believe it will successfully attract foreigners to Taiwan and increase more diplomatic opportunities. However, we also have concern about new media. Why don't you share your idea with us, Vicky?
Yes, social media is a double-edged sword. Without the limitations of time and space, messages and comments, for better or for worse, can be shared with the world in no time. So, Peggy, can you help me explain more?
Of course. Thus, it is important for people to understand that what we post on the internet can be considered diplomacy. When using new media, everyone should take comments more seriously. Only by doing so can we use new media as a beneficial tool and make a Taiwan better place to the world.
Thank you. One, two.
第五队演讲的题目是 Number 3, 计时开始。
Good morning, honorable judges. As we know, Taiwan was forced to drop out of the WHO in 1972. Since that time, we have been trying every possible means to rejoin it or attend the yearly WHA as an observer. As difficult as our diplomatic situation is, we have never given up. Healthcare knows no boundaries.And we Taiwanese hold the same right to a healthy life as anyone else. In fact, many countries, whether they are our diplomatic allies or not, have publicly voiced that Taiwan should attend the WHA. They are convinced that Taiwan can make concrete contributions toward health safety and should not be excluded from the duty of protecting all human beings. What makes other nations think so?What medical contributions has Taiwan made to the world? Let my partners elaborate to you.
It's globally acknowledged that Taiwan has advanced medical equipment, professional expertise, and a world-class healthcare system. In fact, Taiwan has made great achievements in fields such as liver transplantation, facial plastic, or reconstructive surgery.Cardiovascular treatment, and reproductive medicine, just to name a few, according to a 2012 documentary by National Geographic, Taiwan's medical industry ranked exceptionally high in the world. It achieved the highest ranking in Asia and was third in the entire globe. Over the past five decades, Taiwan's high quality and affordable medical serviceHas attracted thousands of people from around the world to come for treatment. Showing great love for people and passion for life, Taiwanese doctors have cured many patients, giving them and their families a new lease on life. This past March, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs produced a short film called A Perfect Pair. It tells the true story of a Vietnamese girlwho came to Taiwan for a series of complex surgeries that saved her leg from amputation and changed her life. Viewed by millions of people from around the world, the film proves that Taiwan can strongly contribute to global health.
Moreover, Taiwanese medical personnel regularly form volunteer groups,which go abroad to provide free care for those in need. Many NGOs and charities have also been dedicated to international humanitarian relief for years. Take Taiwan Root Medical Peace Corps, TRMPC for example. It is a non-governmental, non-profit organization founded by Dr. Qi Chun-Liu. Since it founded in 1995, it has joined talented medical personnel with enthusiastic volunteers to form medical service groups. With the belief that everyone has the basic right to health care, TRMPC provides free medical service and health education not only domestically, but also internationally. Another example is the Ciji Foundation, a charity founded by Dharma Master Zheng Yan, which has expanded its service to medicine over time. Since Master Zheng Yan,consider illness the most painful suffering in life, Ciji has put great emphasis on medical work and established Ciji International Medical Association in 1998. By the end of 2017, the association, along with more than 500,000 medical personnel and volunteers, had provided free health care in 50 countries.
It's undeniable that Taiwan plays an indispensable and irreplaceable role in promoting global health. We have admirable medical techniques, which have created countless medical miracles. We have a sound healthcare system, which is worthy of any country's analysis and emulation. We have great medical personnel, who are not only busy doing medical research, but also saving people's lives. We have many organizations, be they official,or non-governmental, which are engaged in international medical missions, sending our selfless love to every corner of the world. And then there is us, as well as a great number of young people like us, who are concerned about the world and eager to help others, while we are doing our best to protect the right to health for all people. We also have a high hope that the hard work and devotion of Taiwanese people can be seen and recognized by the whole world. Global health needs Taiwan, and Taiwan can help a lot. Thank you.
Number 1, 计时开始.
Good morning, everyone. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs has contributed greatly to our daily lives. Next, we're going to talk about how exactly it affects our lives.
With the rapid development of technology, interactions among countries are getting intense and inseparable than ever before. Thus, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs plays an important part in this globalization era. MOFA is dedicated to promoting interactions among foreign countries through the channels of economy, tourism, education, and culture. The work of MOFA and the relation to our daily lives would be illustrated in the following speech.
First, in terms of economy, by joining the World Trade Organization, Taiwan is able to export domestic products to other 143 countries at lower customs tariffs. Many industries like information technology and petrochemical material industry can gain many benefits. On the other hand, the price of foreign products such as vehicles, tobacco, alcohol, or agricultural produce will be lower. People can purchase these daily necessities at a reasonable price and with various options. Furthermore, better economy leads to more jobs in the international community. More foreign companies are willing to start a business in Taiwan, creating a reciprocal partnership between Taiwan and other members. If Taiwan faces trade problems during the process, the representative of Taiwan and other members and other government members will solve the problem immediately.
Apart from the economy, MOFA also provides Taiwanese people convenience who love to travel all over the world. As of 2018, there are 119 countries around the globe that allow Taiwanese tourists to enter without a visa. If you plan to visit Germany, France, or Japan, you can stay there for 90 days at most without applying for a visa. What a convenient policy! The service of visa-free may attract more and more people around the world to visit other countries and consequently boost Taiwan's tourism. What's more, if you encounter an emergency in a foreign country, the ministry's overseas embassy can offer timely assistance. All in all, MOFA's efforts on tourism are showing doors to Taiwan's citizens to the capricious world. Have no time to give yourself a break? Just book a ticket to Japan and enjoy the exotic culture.
What's more, since the ministry is in charge of the connection between Taiwan and other countries, it makes good use of the opportunity to learn the beauty of each culture. The project of international student exchange is one of the great examples. Through joining the project, students in Taiwan should have chance to experience different cultures, walk out of their comfort zone, and discover the world. As for other citizens, they can attend various festivals and activities about foreign arts and culture, which the ministry frequently holds. This October, the ministry cooperated with Tainan government and held Nanying International Folklore Festival. the event is a wonderful platform for people to learn domestic and international cultures and arts. Moreover, being the host country is also a great method to enhance our civil diplomacy and let foreign friends experience different parts of Taiwan. Nowadays, diplomacy has already become a vital role in our daily lives. It brings a lot of benefits for us, including economy, tourism, education, and culture. Being a member of the Global Village, we should make the best of the chances which the country provides and broaden our horizons to catch up the pace of the world. Thank you.
Number 2, 计时开始.
Hello, everyone. Nice to meet you. Do you use Facebook? Do you chat with Line? And do you watch videos on YouTube? In today's information age, in order to catch up with the world, people have been many things like shopping, meetings, data transmission, and so on, which took much time to complete in the past. Thanks to new media, people can immediately know anything happening around the world. Therefore, a good combination of online resources is not only a chance to connect with the world, but also an opportunity to make ourselves be seen and understood.
With such social media as Facebook, Line, Twitter, and Instagram, it's easy and convenient to communicate with people around the world. If we can wisely use these online resources, we can also promote diplomacy anytime, because Taiwan is denied almost only participation in international activities. We can surely make our country better known to the world by making great use of these media resources. For example, we can make videos about humanitarian assistance endeavors and concerns about world issues, and then upload them to YouTube so that more people can have a deeper impression that we keep reaching out to a country in need, even though we are in top political situation. Fortunately, new media builds a bridge between people in Taiwan and counterparts in other different countries. Nowadays, by posting photos and sharing everything happening in our daily lives, we can surely meet more foreign friends through platforms such as Twitter and Instagram.
This way, we learn how to make better communication and develop a closer relationship with the foreigners online. Take my friend for example. I'm surprised to learn that she has many EPLs from Japan, Sweden, Canada, and some other countries on Instagram. I asked her why she would like to make so many foreign pen pals. My friend just laughed and said, because we are global citizens. She really hit a nail on the head, didn't she? Living in a global village, we can do more with new media. In fact, new media plays a crucial role in many ways, like education, business, and culture. It can even be considered to be a great tool for diplomacy. Let's take Shen Xinling for example. She is one of 10 outstanding young persons in Taiwan. Since she was a fourth grader, she has created many more opportunities for other people on the internet. At first, she set up her own website to help her parents to sell clothes. Later, she devised an online system to help farmers promote their fruits. At that time, this was an innovative farm produce marketing in Taiwan. Besides, she developed a website for poor children to learn all the school subjects online for free. The website was first designed to serve students on both sides of the Taiwan Strait, and then had a Cambodian version added to it. So far, over 3 million people have visited this website.
By means of new media,
what she's done has made a difference in diplomacy. She has set a good example for us to promote diplomacy. It is true that the media has changed the way of diplomacy. Thus, by using new media properly, we can not only advertise our country's positions on different international issues, but also promote our image around the world. All in all, it is through media resources that we can do our shares as global citizens, looking for more teammates from abroad, regardless of their races, religions, political beliefs, economic or social conditions. Above all, we should cooperate with them so that we can make the world a better and more harmonious place. This amazing soft power definitely brings us onto the global stage. Come on, everybody. Let's be the bridge, be the change. Through new media, we can surely make Taiwan put on the map. Thank you very much.
各位在座的老师，各位同学，非常谢谢大家来参加我们这次的活动。那我想对大家来讲，这是一个蛮难得的经验。不过我想你们已经做得很好了啊，能够站在台上讲英文，其实已经很不错的一个表现。那我们还是可以给你一些建议，知道让你知道以后可以怎么样在台上做这样的活动的时候，可以有更好的表现。那首先我想第一个先提一下，就是大家在做演讲的时候，记住，讲英文跟讲中文不太一样。讲英文，我曾经听过一个，我在美国念书的时候听过一个老师跟我说，他说你要把你的那个你的 audience 或是你的 reader 当成笨蛋，就是说你要想他们什么都不知道，所以你一开始要先破题，你要帮你的演讲做一个很好的框架。这是一个很重要的地方，所以会建议大家你们在一开始的时候就要先针对你今天的主题做一个大概的一个 outline， 给大家一个 idea， 说我大概今天想讲些什么，有哪些重点，我想这是你可以去加强的。那接下来就是我想今天因为是演讲比赛的部分，所以我们可能也会比较着重在一些像发音的部分，比如说像很多同学你们在念 world， 那个的会听不到。那其实这是我们台湾同学在念英文很常犯的毛病，像 m 这个有时候会有点合不起来。所以这部分我想还是要提醒大家。还有就是 world 这个的，很多同学念起来有点像 word， 他可能念太快了，然后他有一个 l 的音他不见了。那这部分我想要注意，请大家注意一下哈。那接下来就是说，在那个你在演讲到最后，因为我们是团体演讲，所以你会有一个类似像我们中文讲的起承转合，所以我会建议大家在最后的时候，你可以稍微再 restate 你刚刚讲过的东西，哈，提醒你的那个 audience 啊，我们这个演讲这个内容到底重点是什么？那我们有什么样的一个建议这样子哈？那接下来的话，建议大家在台上演讲不要有太多，就是我其实昨天也老师有提过，就是一些动作，其实我想那个是不太必要的哈。那接下来就是在那个讲句子的重音，我发现大家很喜欢讲一些就是尾巴那个，就是说在英文里面我们通常不会太多地方有高音的部分。那还比如说像那个很多学生，有些同学会讲，比如说台湾同学喜欢讲 everybody， 其实要怎么说 everybody？ 那比如说 relationship， 你很多人同学会讲 relationship， 他就会把两个字都放重音，其实这是不对的。所以大家在学单字发音很简单，但是在音调的部分，其实我建议大家再注意哈。那接下来的话就是句子的一些 intonation， 一样昨天严老师有提到，就是 intonation， 我想还是请大家稍微注意一下。那有几个字，有一两个字我想在这边特别提醒大家，那个 abroad， 我发现有同学是念 abroad， 那其实不对的啊 ，abroad， 好，这个要注意哈。那接下来的话，尽量避免用一些我们讲的，我们中文讲英文讲 cliché， 就是我们中文讲的陈腔滥调，就尽量避免用这些东西。因为我想对在英文演讲里面，其实用太多这种东西其实是不太适合的。啊，我们希望你在台上演讲是很自然的，很有自信的，把你想讲的东西很有组织的表达出来。我想这个才是我们希望看到的东西，这样子。那接下来就是你在演讲内容有时候，不要放太多所谓的，就是说有时候我们听起来会觉得有点好像太多的刻板印象在里面。那其实像我发现很多组喜欢用到观光这个东西。好，那其实观光当然很好，但是有时候我们是用我们台湾人的角度来看外国人喜欢什么，但事实上你要去思考外国人到底喜欢的是什么，他其实跟我们想的可能是不一样的，所以这个才是你要去知道去了解去探索的部分。好，不要用我们的角度想，我们可以先去问问看，哎，我认识请老师去帮你问外国同学外国朋友之类的，比如说观光食物，他们比如说老外其实不见得每个都喜欢珍珠奶茶，我遇过老外他是不喜欢珍奶的。好，所以其实这个就是我们可以去思考的，不是用我们的角度去看，我们觉得珍奶很好喝，我也很爱喝啦哈。那但是你要从他们的角度去看看，他们到底对我们的什么东西他是比较想要更进一步去讨去认识的，这个才是你需要去了解的。那不过我想大家都做得非常好哈，那你们值得给大家自己一个很大的掌声，好，谢谢大家。
主办单位各位长官，还有各位老师、各位同学、各位裁判，大家好。那我是最后一个，我讲完了就结束了啊，你就知道你的成绩了。那个，我有些话要想要跟你们说。第一个，我想跟主办单位讲哈，你们安排得非常好，这个流程看来越来越顺利了。不过呢，我只是有一个问题要请教，我觉得这个题目太难了，啊，这个等一下我们是不是请那个外交部的长官来给我们随便答几题？啊，我觉得这个对我们的高中生来讲好像有一点为难了哈。你是给他鼓掌还是给我鼓掌？啊，OK， 好，谢谢。我只是说出我心里的真话了哈。当然他们非常尽力啊，这也问的问题非常专业啊，但是是不是适合我们的高中生？我觉得啦，我们的高中生就应该像高中生的样子，他应该是青年的，他应该是活泼的，啊，他应该是生动的。那，所以我们如果循着这个脉络走下去的话，哈，我等一下会跟学生建议。那另外我要跟我们的这个裁判，讲一下，我非常荣幸跟你们一起在这边当评审哈，因为你们都已经把重要的事情都讲了，所以我最后一个呢，我就可以少讲一些哈。好，非常感谢我们的裁判都非常认真，我要跟各位同学和家长还有老师报告，我们非常非常认真哇！我们这个几次进出呢，其实不是真的休息，我们是去讨论的哦。虽然讨论的时候也有吃点水果什么的啦哈。另外呢，我想跟在座的老师和学生呢，谈一谈。我觉得非常可惜，每一次啊，到了这个第二天的时候啊，就有一大半的16队就不见了嘛，对不对？就是被各位淘汰掉了。那我觉得他们其实也应该来听一听，那或者是说各位参赛的同学，我想你们都是非常认真啊，非常优秀，因为我曾经在不同的这个场合里面看到大概同一批人，下个礼拜又去参加演讲比赛了，然后再下个礼拜又去参加作文比赛了，所以你们都是学校的精英。那我就觉得纳闷有一点哈，为什么我们有一部分的这个裁判所讲所建议的内容哈，每一年都在发生，啊，从来没有断过的。比如说手势，昨天这个严老师讲的这个手势哈，就非常做作的手势，那非常假的笑容，哈，然后队友在讲话的时候频频的点头，表示非常同意。我知道你们同意对了，应该都很同意彼此才对啦，啊，但是就是说如此夸张的表现哈，我向来跟学生的建议是说，我没有特别给你这些假笑、假动作加分。那我会甚至于这次更直白一点的告诉你，可能会影响你的那个成绩哦。
好，所以我在想，是不是老师们把我们这些意见带回去，传给下一届的同学，传给下一届的领队老师？我想很自然的表现，大概是我们所有的裁判，或者是说大部分的裁判想要看到的哈。好，那我再来给学生做一些同学们做一些建议哈。根据我手上拿到的这个评分标准，它45个百分点哈 ，45% 是在这个 English ability and pronunciation。那么这个 English ability， 我发现哈，这个有点问题，因为很多可能是老师的 English ability， 还是学生的 English ability。那你在这边，所以为什么有人会建议我们是不是以后改成 impromptu 还是怎么样的一个情形？我不知道。那主办单位也许可以考虑，但我知道学生的压力也很大。似乎也不必这么的难过。不过如果我记得我在我年轻的时候啊，这个我们参加讲演比赛的时候，英语演讲它也是分两个场次。第一个场次呢就是那个 prepare speech， 那第二天呢就是 impromptu， 那就要抽签了，抽签的就是3分钟啊。我觉得这个在一方面可能你会比较紧张，可是你想想看，在另外一方面你可以少背5篇嘛。你不是来之前已经背了5篇了吗？对不对？你可以少背5篇，说不定这也是一个解套啊。说不定问问同学们，说不定同学们会更喜欢，也不一定。好，所以我刚刚谈的是 English ability 的问题，然后现在看看 pronunciation。Pronunciation 因为它放在第一个45个 45%， 所以它是很重要的一个东西。所以除了刚刚老师们提到的东西哈，我这边。感谢主办单位这么贴心给了我一个桌子，不然我真的看不见。我谈一下这个 pronunciation。以我来看啊，我个人的标准是这样子啊，我可以接受你的这个比较偏英式的发音。我听到有这个比较英式的 English pronunciation， 我听到 American pronunciation， 我还有听到不知道是，你在哪里？我还有听到那个 Indian。pronunciation， 那个很印度腔的那个英语，你还在吗？哦，非常好，我都接受，我都觉得很棒。所以以我个人来说，不管是你讲 abroad， 或者是讲 abroad， 我都可以接受。但是我是听到同学讲 aboard 是什么 a piece of wood 哈，那个 board， 所以那个是不可以，所以。不管所以我可以接受美国腔，我可以接受英式腔，我可以接受什么纽澳腔、印度腔。不过我今天听到最多的这两天还是台湾腔了哈。那台湾腔只要大家清楚一点，慢慢的讲，我觉得还是可以的哈。举几个例子好了，我听到的同学有。重复几次讲的哈，像 therefore， 你可以讲 therefore， 你可以讲 therefore， 都可以。可是 therefore， 你就明显的掉了很多音哈。那我们掉音是一个问题啊。刚刚老师有讲到啊，比如说 all around the world， 那我常常听的 all around the world。然后这个母音分清楚一点哈 ，a 和 e 还是不一样嘛哈，所以你当讲到火车的时候是应该是讲 train， 而不是 train， 哦不是 train。那如果 English ability， 我不晓得可能各位是紧张的关系吧，怎么会说成 informations， 啊这个 information 你大概没有看过它，加 s 吧，啊当别的语言有啊，你到国外去的时候你可能看到一个 i， 对不对？那个机场啊 i。它 I 下面有很多什么 information 什么什么什么，它那个地方可能会有复数，但是在英文里面是没有的哈。好了，另外我再提一下那个 honorable judges， 我怎么听怎么怪啊，那就是说不需要这么的那个 formal 吧。好，我建议一下，这是那这个。请记得我现在是在吹毛求疵的，在你们已经每一位都是很胜利者啊，每一位都是这个精挑细选的，我只是说因为我的工作就是在找学生的毛病，所以这个挑毛病挑久了哈，这个随便挑都有。那我是非常的这个认真，也是非常的刁钻的哈，这个 picky。 好，第二个criterion 是 content 40%。那我觉得各位的 content 哈、哦，似乎都那个方向很清楚，都是我们怎么样去帮助人家啦。我比较看到的是说，我比较希望看到的是说，我们从那么多地方是不是透过交流跟人家学些什么？好，跟人家学些什么？那么，我们似乎对国外的情况好像不太很了解。那个严老师刚刚有举一个例子，比如说在昨天我们看到的戏剧上，如果你说你冒犯了这个回教徒，可能给他吃了猪肉，或者是你自己做了一些这个举动，他大概不会说哦没有关系啦，这一点这只是culture 的不同吧，应该没有什么关系啊。其实我往往我会觉得说，我们是不是把这件事看得太轻松了啊？是不是看得我觉得再认真一点哈，我们去多了解别人的文化。好，最后看到一个 stage manner 15% 啊 15%， 那么stage manners， 我看到各位脸上的笑容，我觉得其实一抹笑容就可以了，好，稍稍的笑一笑就可以了，不必咧嘴然后点头。你有的队伍让我想到，哎，你们有没有看过那个北韩的小朋友在跳舞的时候那个表情？哇，那个笑得真开怀啊，哈！但是他会定格僵在那个地方哈，所以我想你很紧张，我知道，好，你需要笑容，我知道，可能就是太紧张，我发现你是不是有很多 butterflies， 这个 in your stomach， 所以大家都抱着胃，啊，这个手都放在那个，可能都胃疼了，紧张的关系了哈。所以你的手没有办法很自然的放下来，或你要放下来也可以，是不是一定要举在那个腰际那个肚脐以上3公分那个位置啊？我觉得稍嫌做作了些。那么如果你在南部，其实我们都比较那个啦，我们都比较了解大家的紧张啊。可是你到北部去，啊，可能就会这个在比较的名次上。不过啊，我要跟各位提的是，这是今天是我这几年看来哈，我们南区的表现最好的一次哦。好，所以各位，这次到台北去，啊，这个比赛应该会有比以往更好的成绩才对哈。好，我看还有没有最后一点什么来唠叨了？答案是没有。那这个我最后想要提的是，为什么啊？我自己想一个这个解决之道，是不是可以请啊家长、亲友团、老师、同学们提问啊？给主办单位这样一个建议啊，免得他可能有满腹的委屈，觉得说你们这些老师根本不食人间烟火，到底在讲些什么，我准备的多辛苦等等啊。那他们，我们没有这样一个沟通的管道。去年我曾经提过说，哎，你如果愿意的话到屏东大学来啊，那我们可以继续来聊聊。屏东大学不是屏科大，屏科大是要你走很远的，那屏东大学呢就在屏东市区。我非常欢迎跟各位老师同学啊，家长、亲友团多多的讨论，我想就不会每一年有重复的啊老师提的这些事情。你不相信的话，你去那个什么小尖兵的网站去看看去年的啊评审委员讲了些什么，看看前年的评审委员讲了什么啊。或许主办单位可以考虑呢，以后是我们开放跟大家多一个机会做沟通对谈。好，谢谢大家。
今天非常高兴哈，我们左营高中哈，我们校长，哎，校长还，哦，宋老师 ，OK， 好，我们张年校长啊，还有我们左营高中的同仁哈，给我们这么好的场地跟服务哈，那非常谢谢他们。那这个，到南部哈，今天是大太阳哈，所以同学应该是非常热情哈。那这两天的比赛哈，总共我们有31队的队伍参加。那到今天呢，好，今天应该是入围到这个今天的第二天的这个复赛哈，应该会有16队嘛哈，但是有一个学校可能他有一些情况的因故哈，没有来参加这个复赛，是有点可惜啦。不过我们这15队的这个队伍哈，我想都是在我们南部地区哈，在英文的这些表现是非常拔尖、非常突出的哈。先恭喜哈，这我们15队的这个学校哈，先给大家啊，大家给自己一个掌声鼓励一下。那这个 也谢谢非常谢谢公共电视哈，还有外交部哈，跟教育部，我们共同来合办这个比赛哈。那这个后面在应该在台北哈，在公共电视，还有后面的这个决赛哈，总共取18队。那这个决赛呢，未来如果说有获第一名的话哈，还有这个出国的去做交流的机会啊，所以这是非常难得的机会。那我们跟外交部跟教育部呢，都在这个计划上面都琢磨非常深啊，我们也共同来努力哈。好，那接下来呢，就是非常紧张的时刻哈。今天总共15队，那我们来公布一下哈。我想这一次哈，我们比较特别哈，我们先把啊，我们先把这个进入到决赛啊，决赛的这个6所学校，我们先公布出来。首先是序号3，台南市南光高级中学。啊，恭喜。再来是序号5，台南市慈济高级中学，恭喜哈。再来序号17，台南市德光高级中学，接下来序号25，台南市港民高级中学，恭喜。再来序号28，嘉义市协同高级中学，接下来序号这个29，国立金门高级中学，恭喜啊！这个金门是前天就来了，是不是？哦，前天就来哈，非常恭喜，这我们国立学校哈，超级恭喜的哈。接下来呢，公布我们的比赛优良的名单哈。首先是序号2，嘉义市红人女子高级中学，恭喜。再来序号6，高雄市中山高级工商职业学校，恭喜。再来序号12，高雄市道明高级中学。接下来序号16，嘉义市嘉华高级中学。再来序号18，台南市兴国高级中学。再来序号27，屏东县美和高中。再来序号30，高雄市义大国际高中。再来序号31，嘉义市辅仁高中。在序号32，台南市长荣高级中学。好，以上谢谢这些啊得奖的学校哈，谢谢。